Hello everyone. I want to give you an introduction how PLM Change Management is handled in SAP S/4HANA. The following functionalities are available in S/4HANA on-premise, starting with release 2020 FPS1, as well as in Cloud Edition, starting with S/4HANA Cloud Edition 2111. In this video, I want to give you an overview how the matching between engineering change requests and change orders is working in our change record application. I will first show some slides and then jump into the system for a live demo. Please note that we have used the latest S/4HANA on-premise system, which is currently shipped to our customers. It has the state of S/4HANA 2021 FPS0. In general, we are separating the change process into two phases of the ECR. So, engineering change request and ECO, engineering change order. The ECR, request phase, is like the change planning part. During ECR, no change number will be available on the change record. When converting an ECR into an ECO, we are switching from a planning to a change execution phase. This is also the point when a change number will be generated and available on the change record header. This change number will then be used to execute the product changes. In the change request phase, we have the possibility to merge and split change records. Please note that merging and splitting is only possible when no change number is attached to the change record. Merging means that multiple change records can be merged into one single change record. Splitting is exactly the other way around. This means that you can split a change record into another change record. This new target change record can not only be completely new change record, you can also merge and split into already existing change records. During merge and splitting, only the change item get considered. The relation between merged and split change record we call as child and parents and will be shown on a hierarchy view on the change record application. Once we fulfill the change request phase and we want to continue with the change execution, we need to have at least one change number available on our change record. This change number can be automatically generated on change record header level, as well as on each single change items. The generation of this change number is maintained per status. So for the header change number, you can, for example, maintain in customizing, on user status B, please generate a change number and attach it to the header. On item level, the change number generation is handled per item processing status. So for example, once the processing status change started is maintained on an item, then generate a change number for this item and attach it to the change record. This behavior I will explain more in detail in my demo. If you are interested what kind of different statuses we have in our change record application and want to know how these are working, you can watch the customizing video of our status explanations. Let's now jump into the system to have a closer look how the merging and splitting, as well as the change number maintenance and generation is working. First of all, I want to show you how the merge and split is maintained in our customizing. Therefore, you're accessing the customizing transactions SPRO. You're going into our already knowing path via logistics general, product lifecycle management, change records. Then we are going into the setting for engineering changes. In there, we are going into our main customizing of the defined change record types. The merge and splitting is then maintained per change record type. So for example, we are selecting our change record type S01. And on the dialog structure on the left-hand side, we see then on the last entry that we can main merge and split by status. So here we say for which status we allow merge and for which status we allow split. In this example, you see on our user status E0 and E1 merge as well as split is allowed. Let's now jump into the Fury and see how the merge and splitting is working in our system. First of all, we will go into the merge functionality. In this example, I have created two change records, which have change items attached. It's the merge 1 and the merge 2. In the merge 1, we have one document assigned to this change record. You see it exactly here. The status of this change record is in E0, so merge is allowed in the status. In the merge 2 change record, we also see that this merge 2 change record is having the record status E0, and to this change record one material is attached. The material you can also see here on the change objects tab. What we are going to do now, we want to merge these two change records into one change record. Therefore, we are selecting these two change records. We are clicking merge. Then we see that we have these two change records available on this upcoming pop-up. We can say here, do we already merge into an already existing change record? Yeah. Then we can select this already existing change record via the F4 help. Or we can say we want to merge these two change records into one new change record. So this means that we are creating a new one. In this case, we are selecting the checkbox, defining a name for the new change record. We can also give it a description. We are selecting a change record type, and then we are clicking merge. Thereafter, we are seeing that we are directly landing into this new merged change records. It has the type what we just defined in the merge pop-up. It also has the record status E0. It has these two objects assigned of the two other change records, the material and the document. You see it also here. If we now want to check where this change record is coming from, we're going to the hierarchy section called change records here in this release. And here we see that this change record merge 3 is coming from the merge 1 and the merge 2 change records. By accessing these child change records of our new change record, we will also see that the change execution status has been pushed to completed. So this means we can no more longer work with this old merged change record. To show you the split functionality, I have already created one change record with multiple items attached. In this case, two materials as well as two documents. We have also a change record for the splitting of the type S01 in the record status E0. The materials and documents we can also see in the change object sections. In our upcoming example, we now want to split one material and one document into one separate change record. Therefore, we are clicking on the split button and the header area. We are selecting, first of all, the sections which we are going to split, in this case, the documents as well as the materials. In this example, we can also split into an already existing change record, but we can also create again a new one. We need to give this new change record a name. We need to define a change record type of this new one. And then we are defining which change items we are going to split. For the documents, for example, we are selecting the document of the VED file. And for the materials, we can also select the materials which we are going to split. In this example, the 16-9 material number. Once we have fulfilled our split attributes, we are clicking on the split button in this pop-up. Thereafter, you see that our change items which we have splitted are directly getting removed from our initial change record. To access our splitted new change record, we can again go to the child change record section, and there we see that we have a child change record here available called splitted result, what we just have created. By accessing this, we see that this new change record type S01 with these two objects, what we have defined in the splitted pop-up, are created on this change record. Again, we can also switch on the item section and see that this VED document type, as well as the 69 material number, has been splitted into the new change record. As next, I want to show you how the creation of change numbers in change records headers, as well as on change item level, is working. When we are converting our change record from a change request, ECR, into a change order, ECO, this is exactly then this point when a change number is available. This change number is also maintained on change record type level. In the dialog structure, you see some folders which are called change number handling at change record header level, as well as change number handling at change record item level. As a first step, we are selecting our change record type again of S01 and then going into the folder for maintenance of change number handling at change record header. Here we can then define per status if the change number on header level gets created or deactivated. In this example, you see in our record type S01, once the change record is reaching status E5, then a change number on header level will getting created. Once the change record is reaching status E8, then the change number gets deactivated. In addition to that, we can also jump one level deeper. So selecting, for example, the change number creation at status E5. And then we can, in addition, define creation attributes. So for example, we can map the change number description with the change record description. So this means that once the change number gets created, it takes automatically the description of the change record. An additional example of creation attributes can be the valid from date. So this means that the change number valid from date is automatically mapped with the expected completion date of the change record field. In addition to that, we can also define if these two attributes are getting in sync. So in case the valid from date on the change number side gets changed, then in this example, this would also then automatically change the expected completion date on the change record side. Also the other way around, of course. So if the expected completion date on the change record gets changed, then this is also automatically kept in sync with the valid from date of the change number. To show you that change number creation on header level in the system, you see here that I have already created a change record of type S01. We are still in the ECR phase with the record status E4. And what we now want to do, we want to push this change record to E5, to the next status. And then we will see that this change number gets fulfilled and that the description gets mapped. Therefore, we are changing the status in this case automatically, converting into an order to E5. We have here now the record status E5 available. And as you can see here in the change number field, this change number automatically gets generated with the same description of the change record. We can also access this change number. To see some more details out of it to show you how the change number generation on change record item level is working. We first of all going back to our customizing, selecting our change record type, selecting then the folder of the change number handling at change record item level. Here we are first of all then defining per processing status, so per item processing status, on which item processing status we want to generate a change number. In this example, processing status 04 is set. As a next step, we're then jumping to the object types. So we're defining here per object type which kind of change number it needs to consider. We have the following possibilities. First of all, no change number generation for this object type. We can also say that the change number of the header of the change record needs to get considered for this object types, or that we want to create a new change number which is only valid for this selected object type. Last but not least, we can then also for sure maintain that for another processing status, we want to deactivate the change number on change item level. In this example, you see here that for bill of material, we will take the change number from the change record header level. For the inspection plan, we do not want to have a change number available at all. And for the materials, we want to create a new change number. In addition to that, we can for sure also define creation attributes for each of these single change number item creation. Creation attributes are exactly the same that you just have seen on the change record header level. So we can, for example, map the description or map the valid from date of the change number to the change record. To show you this behavior in the system, we're going back to our change record Fiori application. We are accessing this example, the materials. We are selecting one material which is attached to our change record, changing the processing status to change started 04. And then you will see that a new change number is automatically generated on item level. We can also do this for sure for the second material. And then you will see that additional change number get generated. As you see, for example, for the BOM, we defined that for the BOM, the change number should be considered from the header level. So once we are changing the processing status of the bill of material, you will see that the change number from the header, 8400 in the end, will get considered. To also show you how the change numbers automatically get closed, we will quickly jump back into the customizing. Going back to the change number handling at change record header level, here you see that we have defined on user status E8. The change number needs to get deactivated. So this we are also trying to simulate on the system. We are pushing our change record to status E8. And there you see then that the record status gets pushed to E8 when we are accessing the change number. You will also see that the change number status switched from active to inactive, status 2 in this case. Thank you, everyone. I hope I give you an overview what kind of different possibilities you have in a change request and a change order phase in your process. You should now understand how merging and splitting of change records is working and how the change number generation on change record header and change item level is set up.